Today we'll be talking about the concept behind population dynamics. Every population, that is, every group of individuals of a single species living in the same general area, faces population demographic factors that affect population size in two ways. They either increase or decrease population size.
These factors include birth, death, immigration or when new members enter the population but not through birth, and emigration or when members leave the population but not through death. Birth and immigration, of course, increase the population, while death and emigration decrease it. The effects of these factors are not mutually exclusive. They can happen simultaneously or one after the other, depending on the circumstances of the population. When a population increases, there are a number of ways these can be depicted. To visualize the state of a population, its growth may be depicted through exponential or logistic growth. When depicted through exponential growth, the graph shows a J-curve, which indicates that the population increases indefinitely. On the other hand, logistic or sigmoidal growth includes the variable K for carrying capacity. With this new variable, growth initially increases rapidly, but slows down as carrying capacity is reached and eventually declines as it is exceeded. These results in an S-shaped growth pattern. Knowing these growth patterns is vital since they can help us look at the limits to population growth. We can estimate when the carrying capacity is exceeded and we can adjust our future actions accordingly to fit the demands of carrying capacity in spaces that will sustain life in a particular environment. Since we live in a world where almost all resources are not unlimited, our planet can only host a limited number of organisms. Knowing limits to population growth can help us manage its increase as well as conserve resources like food.
Moving on, other factors that affect population size are density-independent factors and density-dependent factors. An example of a density-independent factor is extreme climate events like typhoons or droughts. These occurrences will happen regardless of population size and may produce sudden changes in population size. Factors like these are not conscious of keeping population sizes in check. For instance, the El Niño episode that occurred in the Philippines in 1997 and 1998 resulted in a 46-80% decline in the coral cover at Bolinao, Pangasinan. Coral reef bleaching decreases marine biodiversity, which has a significant impact on ecological stability and productivity of marine ecosystems. Meanwhile, density-dependent factors affect a population through increasing or decreasing birth and death rates, in a way that is directly related to the density of the population. For example, fishes need food, oxygen, and a way to detoxify water of their own wastes in order to survive in a fish tank. These factors are density dependent because they will become drastically more limiting as more fish are added to the fish tank. More fishes mean that more of them need to share the available food and oxygen, and the easier the tank gets dirty. In this way, density dependent factors limit population growth. Overall, these are the various population dynamics governing populations.